Hey guys, today we're going to be going over how to repair Game Boy Color games. There are some common issues that can cause your game to have weird glitches or freeze up or just have graphical errors, and I'm going to show you multiple ways to fix them. With me I have Frogger 2, one of the first games I ever owned, and it does have some problems. Let's go over how to diagnose what's causing the problem in your game. The most common issue for these old games is for it to get stuck at the Game Boy screen, but if you look carefully at the screen, it will actually tell you what's wrong with the game. The solid black bar means it can't read the cartridge at all, and the garbled text means it's having a hard time reading the data on the cartridge. The more garbled the text, the less it can read. The closer to Nintendo, the more it can read. If you have either of these two issues, that probably just means your cartridge is dirty. That's a pretty easy fix. You can simply clean the pins using a cotton swab and some isopropyl alcohol. That should get most general dirt off the pins and should be enough to boot up your games. If after this your game still doesn't boot up and you've tried it in multiple Game Boys, you're going to have to go a little bit more in depth. So what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to go out and buy a game bit screwdriver or make one yourself. I'll have a link below to both buying and making your own. After that, you'll need to actually open up the game cartridge and you'll have to clean the pins manually. I found that using one of these artist erasers is actually really handy. It does a better job of cleaning off all the grime and stuff on the pins than a simple Q-tip will. That can certainly help more stubborn games get past the Game Boy screen. While you have the game open, you can go ahead and clean the board too. You can use the same cotton swabs and isopropyl alcohol to just clean out the board, make sure there's no dust in there, just do a quick inspection, and if you had any stains on the board, you should definitely try to get rid of those too. Alright, as soon as you're done, just go ahead and close up the game, put the screw back in, and boot up the game. Hopefully by now you should at least be able to get past the boot screen. Alright, so the game boots up just fine, I'm able to start a new game, and there's no graphical glitches in sight in this level. So, that sounds like the game's ROM seems to be working perfectly fine. Though you may notice the profile select screen looks a little bit messed up. The very fact that I can't delete any of these corrupted profiles means that it's more than just an issue of a corrupted save file. The simplest way to delete a corrupted save file is to simply desolder the battery that's attached to the board. That's the battery that keeps the save file in there. You gotta keep it desoldered for at least 30 seconds, ideally, to wipe the save file. Alright, now you can just boot up the game as is, and if your corrupt save file is gone, that means you're good to go. Just go ahead and resolder the battery and start your new save file. If your corrupt save file is still there, it might be an actual issue with the SRAM chip that's used to hold the save files. This is where things get a little bit more messy. Alright, what we gotta do is reflow the solder on all the pins of the SRAM chip. There are a few chips on this board. The SRAM chips are generally on the left side if it uses an SRAM chip. And so what we gotta do is just tap with the soldering iron for a few seconds. If you want, you can move it back and forth a little bit, just to move the solder around a little bit. It's fairly easy, it just takes a little time to do. Double check your work. If you lose your place, the pins that have already been done should look a little bit wet from the melted solder. If some of them look a little bit dry, feel free to go over them again. Just want to make sure you have a good clean connection on all of them. Alright, now let's boot up the game. And it looks like all the corrupted save files are now gone. We can re-solder the battery and we're good to go. Alright, so maybe your game boots up just fine and your save files work just fine, but you're getting some weird graphical glitches. Well, just like with the undeletable save files, we gotta break out the soldering iron. This time we're gonna need to reflow all the pins on the ROM chip, which is usually on the right. So again, leave the soldering iron on each pin for just a few seconds. You can move it up and down the pin a little bit just to move the solder around. And then once you're done with all the pins, you should be good to go. Alright, next thing we're going to cover is freezing shortly after boot up. If you get a successful Nintendo logo, but you just get stuck at a white screen or it boots up for a few seconds and it just crashes, that may be a problem with your MM1134 chip. I'll show you where it is right now, you can see that. Reflowing the pins on this chip may actually fix the problem. The thing this chip does is when you're playing your games on your Game Boy, your save battery is not being used. The SRAM is being powered by your Game Boy, but this chip will say that as soon as the Game Boy is off, it will resort to using the battery inside of the cartridge. Alright guys, I hope this guide was useful, and I hope I explained everything well enough for you. If you have any questions, just post a comment, and I guess I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.